I'm Veronica Vance. Coming up, the end of January heats up with the Ferndale Blues Festival. We enjoy an evening at the Andiamo Showroom in Warren, and then we visit the upscale Hill Gallery in Birmingham, so stay tuned.
Production funding for this program was made possible by the Detroit Metro Convention and Visitors Bureau, driving tourism growth in Metro Detroit since 1896. More information is available at visitdetroit.com.
Hey, the temperature may be cool outside, but so are the Blues, and I'm in downtown Ferndale for their annual Blues Festival, right at the crossroads of Woodward and Nine Mile. You can hear all kinds of great music in their restaurants and bars. Blues are everywhere. They're even here in the rec center. Behind the Ferndale Blues Festival. Oh, you're well known all around, eh?
Yeah, it's a fun time of the year. We started this 11 years ago, and for a number of reasons, you know, we wanted to keep the blues alive in Metro Detroit. Mm-hmm. We should have a big blues festival in the Motown, I think. We wanted to raise money for charity. We have a great nightlife, and so we organize with all the clubs, the restaurants, the library, the community centers, and we bring music to the town for 9 days straight.
That is so awesome. And it's just a small donation, but then all the money goes to charity, correct?
We've been raising, over the last 11 years, we've probably raised well over $150,000. Wow. For two charities, AIDS Prevention Education, mm-hmm. and Ferndale Youth Assistance, that helps at-risk kids throughout the district with all sorts of programs and camp. Mm-hmm. But it's also cool, I think it's cool for the residents and the visitors who come here, because you've been cooped up in the house all winter long, and it's a time that you can get out of the house. It's cold outside, but it's warm inside the clubs, and we usually bring some pretty amazing music. I'm always pleased, and sometimes I find myself just sitting there letting the music wash over me, and I'm just saying, this is totally cool. You know, when we first started this, we had five or six clubs. Now, Dino's, which is the anchor of the Ferndale Blues Festival, mm-hmm. every year he wins the Blue Pig Award, which is the famous award that for who raises the most charity. He puts on the Blues Barbecue, which is extremely popular. But places like Como's, How's Bayou, which is a bluesy New Orleans place, they've always been part of it. And then this year we got a club over in Hazel Park, our sister city to the east. Max Dugans is holding a bunch of concerts. And then our sister city to the west, Royal Oak Charter Township, as you know, had some really good music earlier this evening. We have, you know, events that kids can go to. There's brunches, there's jazz, there's even 80s and disco music. There's really something for everyone, and that's, again, that's all about Ferndale and our region, is it's diverse. So whatever you like, you'll find it. You come down, and maybe you get something to eat, and you listen to some really good music. And the best of all are the people. We have warm, friendly people here, and everyone gets along.
All right, well, sounds like they're getting ready to jam in there. Should we go check them out?
Let's boogie.
All right.
All right.
All right, so Dino, the man himself. So tell me, why do you like to be part of the Blues Festival?
You know, the Blues Festival in Ferndale is something that happens every year. It's now the Blues and Music Festival, so that we're getting involved with other genres of music. We're having a good time with it.
Do your customers really appreciate it?
We have 9 nights in a row of live music.
Oh, wow.
They really appreciate it. It's something that we do to try to be part of the community, give back to the community. We pay for the bands. We ask for donations. Come down to the Ferndale Blues and Music Festival. Have a good time here. There's a lot going on all over town. Have a good time.
He's a big blues fan, so we tried to find some bars down here to come and enjoy the festivities.
You got to support the Blues Society, because it's a great, great community. We love it. We love the music.
Enjoy the show.
Go Blues!
We're looking for something to do, and came across the blues bands.
was really cool. Now I'm off to another place. Well, here we are in Como's. It's a Ferndale landmark. They're serving up some great pizza and some cool blues. Exciting to have this going
on
in here.
Yes, yeah. It is. This time of the year, it's a plus.
Yeah. Well, you've got a great band here.
Howard Glazer.
They're really great.
Yes, they are.
Do you guys have live music here quite a bit?
Yes.
Then? You do?
Every other week.
I mean,
otherwise, we have a disc jockey.
Okay. And then, for the Ferndale Blues Festival, you devote 9 days to all blues music.
Blues.
Oh, that's awesome. Just giving you a small taste of what the Ferndale Blues Festival is all about, but if you've missed something, you've got 9 days and over 20 venues to get on and experience this great music. Plus, it's a great way to beat the winter blues and experience the bright lights in the big city. There are 11 Andiamo restaurants scattered throughout Metro Detroit, so no matter where you are, you're never far from great Italian food. But today we are at their flagship restaurant where it all started in Warren on 14 Mile, just between Mound and Van Dyke. Now here it's more than just a restaurant. They've got a bar to sit and relax at, they've got, of course, the great Italian food, but they've also got a celebrity showroom. They get big name acts that come in here. You can rent it out for a wedding, a corporate event, or whatever. So Andiamo, let's go.
L'una in mezzo al mare, mamma mia, si salterà. L'ora bella per danzare, che in amor non mancherà.
Well, the name Andiamo, the name of the restaurant, the full name is Andiamo Italia, which means, Andiamo means let's go, Italia to Italy. So that's how the name came about.
The food, what region of Italy is the food from?
You know, all of our menu is the whole province of Italy. You know, we have some northern Italy dishes, some southern Italy dishes. So we cover really the whole map of Italy.
Any signature dishes?
Well, I think that we specialize in veal, and our homemade pastas are, you know, really our signature dishes.
So whenever you're ordering pasta at any Andiamo, it's always homemade then? Fresh?
Yes, everything's homemade. We have three little Italian ladies back there, and that's all they do is make pasta.
That's so cute. They're back there making pasta as we're out here talking.
Yeah.
And so this is sort of the flagship one. This also has the showroom as well, right?
Yes, this has a large banquet facility attached to it. Some of our restaurants also have banquet facilities. Mm-hmm. This particular one has the largest one. And we also use the banquet facility as a showroom. They have live entertainment, usually Wednesday through Saturday in the lounge area. So, yeah, there's something for everybody at Andiamo. But the best part is the great food and the great service.
The great food and service, all right. Well, can we take a peek at the banquet room?
Yeah, let's go.
Showroom where you come to see live shows, banquets. I mean, what exactly goes on in here?
Well, a little bit of everything, as you said. It's a banquet hall, first of all, and we do a lot of weddings, a lot of social functions. We do corporate business. We can seat about 700 people in here.
Oh my gosh, that's huge.
Yeah, it's a large theater. And then as a showroom, mm-hmm. We have different configurations of the tables, so we can put about 800 people in here for the showroom.
So you get some big names that come in here, right?
Yes, we do. We've had, you know, really the who's who. We've had Howie Mandel as comedy, Don Rickles as comedy, Joan Rivers, singers. We've had Engelbert Humperdinck. We've had Paul Anka, country. We've had Lone Star.
Lots of neat options. I hear they're getting ready for a show tonight. Tonight is what's tonight?
Tonight we have a show. It's called Tony and Tina's Wedding. And this is a show that we reoccur here, it plays here about four times a year. It's a great show, it's very entertaining. This for tonight, it does include the food. It's a one package deal.
One package deal.
That's it, Donna, we're breaking up!
You breaking up with me? No, I'm breaking up with you, did you hear it? Who broke up with me first? I broke up with him!
Thank you for showing me around.
Thank you very much, nice to see you.
There's so much drama and so much fun going on all at the same time. They really pull you in. So you're making the homemade pasta for all the restaurants here, yes?
Every day.
Every day making a homemade pasta. Wow. So it goes from here on to your plate? You can't get any fresher than that, can you?
No, it's fresh, yeah. There you go.
All right, thank you.
I'm of Belgium, but boy, when I come here, I am an Italian. Trust me.
Well, hi, Peter. Thank you for sitting down with me. I'm so excited to taste some of this food. It smells wonderful. So what do we have here?
Veronica, we have the lasagna a la bolognese.
A la bolognese, okay.
Bolognese, and it is a traditional 14-layer lasagna.
14 layers.
14 layers.
Wow.
With the meat sauce and ricotta cheese in between each layer.
Mm-hmm. And so, Peter, what do you have here?
It is a fletto di manzo. Filet of beef, mm-hmm. Char grilled 8-ounce steer filet mignon, along with the oven roasted red skin potatoes, mm-hmm. and some Swiss char also. It's also topped with zip sauce, which is vegetable consomme and folded butter. And the dessert is a traditional Italian birthday cake. It is a white cake infused with cannoli filling.
You know, it's something else I noticed too. So you have your own wine. Andiamo has its own wine?
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's Andiamo Nero d'Avolo. Nero d'Avolo is a grape varietal such as Merlot or Cabernet.
Shall we sample some of the food?
Definitely.
Okay. So I'm going to dig into these 14 layers of lasagna here. The meat sauce smells wonderful. What a difference homemade pasta makes. That is so good. Perfect amount of cheese on it. This is yummy.
Nice and tender.
Wow, yeah, even my butter like just sliced right through that. That's yummy. I love the sauce. So we get Nero d'Avolo.
Nero d'Avolo.
Nero d'Avolo, my Italian's not very good. That's very good. Very nice and light and fluffy. Oh, that's very good. I like all the chocolate curls on the side. Is that kind of typical too?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Also homemade in the back.
Well, Peter, thank you so much.
You're welcome, Veronica.
For letting me sample this delectable food. It was fantastic.
Thank you for joining us.
And lucky us, there are 11 Andiamo locations throughout Metro Detroit. So no matter where you are, you can get some of this fine Italian food anytime or any place. Cheers.
Cheers.
There are plenty of things to see and do in Metro Detroit this month, and our calendar of events is up next to point you in the right direction.
Cindy Williams stars in Mom's Gift at Meadowbrook Theater, and the DSO celebrates songs from the 60s. See spectacular ice sculptures at Plymouth's Ice Festival. Then catch the new production of The Phantom of the Opera. The ultimate fishing show drops anchor in Novi, and the auto show rolls into Cobo to debut the latest designs. Enjoy winter fireworks at Rochester's Fire and Ice Festival, and City Theater gets invaded by a sexy, fast-paced comedy. Explore Comerica Park, see the players and more at Tiger Fest. Then make a new friend during Sesame Street Live. Learn how to fix it yourself at the Novi Home Show, then get your blues on during Ferndale's Blues Festival. Take the polar plunge at New Baltimore's Winterfest, then watch giant trucks get smashed at Monster Jam. To learn of any changes, log on to visitdetroit.com or call 1-800-DETROIT.
I'm Melissa. I'm from Livonia. I found a lot of great energy and excitement in the arts community going on in the city right now. The DIA and MOCAD.
Hey, if you're looking for culture in the D, we've got a ton of art. If you're like me, walking into an art gallery can be a little intimidating, but we were at the Hill Gallery in downtown Birmingham, where they're dispelling the notion that it needs to be. It's basically like coming into a museum where they really want you to appreciate their contemporary fine art and their great American folk art.
Hi, I'm Pam Hill, and I am the co-director, along with my husband, Tim Hill. I want to give you a tip about something that's going on in Birmingham, and that is the public art, which we call here cityscapes. And we have on display 9 pieces of outdoor sculpture that you will enjoy, and it's there to be seen by you.
It was okay that I did that. Now for this, you need a really big wall. Well, so Pam, tell me a little about the Hill Gallery. I mean, is it intimidating? It's intimidating to somebody who doesn't know a lot about art. But you're welcome to come in and take a look around, correct?
Absolutely, absolutely. That notion of being feeling like one is intruding when they go into a gallery, or feeling like, well, because they're not a buyer, maybe they shouldn't come in. That is absolutely the opposite of the reality. The reality in a gallery is that the works in the gallery, any gallery, are made by artists who really, really want to have people look at their work. Most of what we have right now, these are all highly recognized, really internationally known artists. It's kind of a way to kind of share, you know, the power of national American art with our local audience.
So this is sort of unusual. What are we standing next to here?
This piece is made by an artist whose name is Jean Heistein, a New York-based artist. And Jean deals with simple shapes, but the making of the pieces are very complex. Mm-hmm. And the fact that it is floating in space. It's weightless. So how a piece of art is presented has a lot to do with our response to it.
Hmm. I know what I'm thinking about. Wonder what she's thinking about. I'm thinking about, why am I standing like this? So you have a mixture of contemporary art, but then you also have folk art in here, correct?
That's right. So right here, this is a piece that comes out of the field of American folk art.
Folk art.
Father Time is a symbol that we see, you know, all the time. And Father Time here, who is pointing down to Earth, and he's suggesting that morality and ideal behavior should be now, because the symbol of death, the scythe, is saying, look, your life may not be forever.
So this is a great example of folk art, but behind us, this is an awesome contemporary piece.
This piece is by a very important American sculptor, Mark de Souvereau. And Mark does large-scale works He's in museums all over the world. Mm-hmm. And his work, some of Mark's pieces actually get up to 72 feet in the air. Mm-hmm. This would be a small piece. This is, but it's an exquisite piece. So what we have is cut steel that looks like it's easy to do. It's very difficult to cut steel. And then we have this element at the top that spins. And then we have another element above that also moves. So we basically have a double motion going on.
So we've got some lovely stainless steel here. Behind me we've got Anne, and I'm thinking about going pink too. So what do we have here? One very abstract piece and then one piece that certainly is quite different. Can you explain the
dynamic?
Yeah, exactly.
And again, this is a kind of juxtaposition or a placement that Tim and I really like to do in the gallery, because we like to show how things are somewhat similar and mm-hmm. how they're very different. So in this case, the similarity is color. And so we have, you know, red, green, white, blue, mm-hmm. and the same red, green, white, blue happening over here.
Right.
And but this is a really exceptional example of a Native American Sioux Indian vest. And this would have been done right around 1890.
Oh, wow.
And we have the really beautiful reduced geometry that you find in Native American design. Michael Goldberg is creating like a cacophony of form. He's putting together shapes and colors and shifting moments that suggests, well, if you're looking or listening to music, this would be like jazz at its wildest. Mm. Veronica, I want you to see this collection of American whirligigs that we're showing.
Whirligigs?
Yes, these are whirligigs. And the idea of a whirligig comes from the whirly. And the whirly is the fan blade, the like windmill blade that actually would create the energy to move the figures. So whirligigs are also animated. This is Philip Perlstein. He's an American expressionist. Philip is in over 65 museums.
Wow.
Just about every museum you can name owns at least one Philip Perlstein. There's an abstraction and there's a lot of realism in Philip's work.
Well, Pam, thank you so much.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. I loved it.
You've been so informative and so educational.
Thank you.
The Hill Gallery really is making art accessible to everyone. Great job you're doing.
Thank you, and we hope to have lots of visitors.
Things are happening in Detroit that are going to reinvent the American city.
Those of us who have been here a long time can tell you that it's never been more vibrant.
And it really represents the future, what the future can be and what the future is becoming.
Let's start at 5 a.m. We have joggers that are running through our state park, that are running on the riverfront.
I kind of like that Detroit has its own vibe right now. Like, it's awesome to be Chicago and it's awesome to be New York, but we kind of have like this underdog thing going on.
Visitors come in from out of town and they absolutely adore the city of Detroit.
When they get here, what they see is different than what they've come to expect.
I've been all over the country, and downtown Detroit is as safe as anywhere I've been.
We have a lot of people, especially our generation, who are doing everything we can to build it up.
So in a way, it feels like being in a kind of lively college town in the middle of Detroit.
It's really a very compact downtown and a very exciting one because it has so much great architecture, great cultural institutions.
Lots of restaurants, coffee shops.
Just walking, there's tours to do, there's museums to see, art.
We've got Campus Martius Park, one of the best urban parks in the United States.
The DIA, the cultural center.
We have a farmer's market.
It's easy to get from here to Campus Martius to Greektown, just walk all over the place.
The Fox Theater, the DAC.
There is so much to do in this city, and it's not like every other city.
All of us in downtown Detroit recognize that safety is the key to everything.
Come to Detroit and see for yourself.
You gotta see it to believe it.
Well, that's our show. Thanks for watching. I'm Veronica Vance. And remember, if you would like more information on any of the places we visited, log on to visitdetroit.com. So until I see you next time, go out and explore on your own and discover the D.
To learn about discounts and special offers for featured attractions, plus how to get copies of Visit Detroit magazine, click on visitdetroit.com.
Hang on, I gotta figure out how to turn it. Always something happening here. You never know what. Oh, hang on. Oh, how's that? Is that better? Keep watching it. Thank you.
Did that happen often?
No.
I don't want to do even to get more direct.